for which St. Paul writes, all of us were baptized into Christ Jesus, were baptized into his death, by baptism into his death, we were buried together with him, so that just as Christ is raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in new life. For if we've been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection. Day of her baptism, Bernadette put on Christ, in the name of Christ, in the day of Christ's coming, may she be clothed with glory.
Please be seated, and I invite Ms. Ingrid to come forward to speak words of eulogy.
Kate Meal Afolcha, 100,000 welcomes. I would like to acknowledge with deep respect and gratitude that we are gathered today on the unceded traditional territories of the Musqueam, Squamish, and Tsleil-Waututh nations, Haichka. Thank you all for joining us today to pay tribute to Anne Bernadette Percy, Ni Dunn. Your presence, both in person and online, is greatly appreciated today. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Ingrid Mary Percy. I'm one of Bernie's five children, Anne, Eamon, Ingrid, David, and Hillary. It is a special honor to deliver the eulogy for my beautiful, strong Irish mother. It is never easy to say goodbye, but it is so very important. We are here because Bernadette meant so much to all of us. It's hard to put into words how much Bernie will be missed and what a positive impact she made on each of us and the world. Anne Bernadette Percy Ní Dunn was born in Dublin, Ireland on September 16, 1929 to Annie Harriet Dunn Ní Beckett Flood and Joseph Dunn. She was one of 10 children, Thomas, Pierce, Maureen, Eamon, Emmett, Deborah, Robert, Bernadette, Nora, and Catherine. They were a famously close-knit family, each looking out for the others. And that is a value that my mother instilled in us as well, the importance of family. Bernie loved her mammy, her daddy, and all her brothers and sisters, but she was particularly close to her sister Nora. In the kitchen of our family home, a small plaque has hung for decades below Auntie Nora's photo that reads, "A sister is a lifetime friend." Bernadette was enormously proud of her father's contribution to the 1916 Easter Rising against British rule in Ireland that led to an independent Irish Republic. She fashioned the living room of our house in Carisdale into a veritable museum that paid tribute to both the country and to Irish history. Bernadette was a free spirit, an adventurer. As a youth, she joined Enoiga, the Irish Youth Hostel Association, where she made lifelong friends and was honored with a lifetime membership, which she carried in her wallet right up until the day of her death. Every weekend as a young woman, Bernadette trod the hills and vales of the Wicklow Mountains and beyond with her hiking companions. Her love of the outdoors continued throughout her life, and gardening was a passion. It was through Enoiga that she met her husband, Trevor Percy, on the eve of her 21st birthday and his 23rd birthday. Together, they built a life of adventure and family across the globe and passed their sense of wanderlust, internationalism, and fearlessness to their 5 children. Their mutual sense of adventure took them to Canada in 1957, but maintaining roots to Ireland and connection to family endured as a top priority. Returning to Ireland every 2 years provided the family with an expanded sense of the world and a deep-rooted connection to ancestral lineage and culture. After working at the Bay and Woodwards for decades in Canada, whilst always prioritizing her children and family, when Bernie was required to retire at age 65, she continued to serve her community as a volunteer with the Busy Bees at the Carisdale Senior Center until her passing. She was tickled pink to be recognized as Volunteer of the Year in 2014. I know that each of you are very saddened by Bernadette's death, and today, as we grieve together, I want to highlight what made Bernadette so special in the words of some of those who were also close to her. Quote, "Bernie was a devout Catholic. She lived a life of quiet strength and unwavering faith. Heaven is a brighter place with her there, along with her beloved Eamon and the rest of the clan. I will always be grateful for the unconditional love she showered on me and pray that I will feel her warm embrace and hear her magical laughter again." Unquote. Quote, "Bernie is a great daughter of Ireland. I thank her for all the great times she has given to our family." Unquote. Quote, "Bernie had a quick wit, charming stories, and a supersized heart. I will always feel the warmth of her smile." Unquote. Quote, "We were blessed to have Bernie cross our paths. Her children were her life. She will always be with them." Unquote. Quote, Auntie Bernie was an icon for us growing up, always ready to take us somewhere, do something exciting with us, tell us stories of journeys she had been on, and when we were good, she would often slip some money into our pocket for a few sweets. Ordinary experiences took on an extraordinary dimension with Bernie. A walk down the street was filled with stories of wonderful people who lived behind the doors. A cold day on the beach in Ireland was like being in Florida. A sandwich on a hike became a delicious meal, and she could outrun and catch us so easily when we played games. If ever we were bold and needed a reprimand, she would explain we didn't really mean to do what we did because we had a headache or a toothache or the rain just got to us. The one thing that all of us were sure was that she loved and delighted in each one of us, unquote. Bernadette was special and she mattered. She was here and she made a powerful impact on our lives. Bernadette leaves behind a host of nieces, nephews, grandchildren, one great-grandchild, friends and family that will remember her and hold her in their hearts forever. We will miss Bernie dearly. I will close with a quote from Bernadette's favorite song, because as we know, if you tell me your favorite song, I will know who you are. Ring a ring a rosy, as the light declines, I remember Dublin city in the rare old times. Karamahadgut, go nairi on Boherlat. Thank you, and may the road rise to meet you. Haichka.
Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. I am Father Terry Bileski, a former pastor of this year's parish, and I've been invited by Ingrid and children to preside at this Mass of Christian burial. First of all, brethren and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Now in the quietness of our own hearts and minds, let us offer a personal prayer for the repose of the soul of Bernadette and the consolation of her family. And we gather all these prayers up to this one prayer to God our Father. O God, whose nature is always to forgive and to show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servant Bernadette, whom you've called to journey to you, and since she hoped and believed in you, grant that she may be led to our true homeland to delight in its everlasting joys, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated, and I invite the first reader forward.
This is a reading from Song of Songs. My beloved speaks and says to me, arise, my love, my fair one, and come away. For now the winter is past. The rain is over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth. The time of singing has come. The word of the Lord.
Thanks. Is there a reader leading the song?
Good morning, my name is Hillary, I'm Bruna's youngest. Just want to thank you all for being here in person and online, we really appreciate it. Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness, for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, and my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
And the next reader.
reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again I say rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Jesus Christ. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" And Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. In listening to the eulogy and looking at the tricolor flag and the casket and the floral emblems on the family here, one can certainly grasp the idea that Bernadette was certainly steeped in her Irish heritage. So was my mother. She was born in Ireland also. And that's something that was very much part of her being. And now after a long life of, 94 years, I believe it was said, Bernadette has died. Medical science has its own definition of death, but in theology, we describe it as when the soul is separated from the body. In the book of Ecclesiastes, it speaks of that in a rather poetic way, because there's certain experiences that we really do not understand, and it's hard to put them in a prose style, but poetry can help us grasp some of it. It speaks about the body going back into the earth from which it came and the soul going to God. In the book of Hebrews, it states there that after death comes judgment. And sometimes that term, it means different things, but somebody might get the idea judgment means somebody's in court because they've done something wrong. Well, not necessarily so. In the gospel passage there, Jesus is saying, I'm going to prepare a place for you. He's also preparing the person for that place, which ultimately is to come into the presence of our God. In this gospel passage, Jesus speaks to his disciples that he's going to go away. This is not something they wish to hear about, because he said it in this way, that he's going to be handed over to the scribes, the Pharisees. He suffered and died and rise on the third day. Thomas, the apostle, is puzzled by this, and he wants to know the directions. Peter and Jesus answered him, not with any earthly directions, but with the assurance that he, Jesus, is the way, the truth, and the life. The Lord says that to know what and where heaven is, we must remain with Jesus and in him, and he in us. And when we come to that great mysterious experience of life beyond this, our God will see to it that we're not just accused of wrongdoing, but healed. The deep healing, the joy and fulfillment which heaven is. And our access to this is through Jesus. What that fulfillment is, it will depend on the needs of the particular, and wounds and searchings of the particular individual. Generally, it is fulfillment. And for this, we assist Bernadette by this Mass and by our prayers. We call to mind, too, just as Bernadette was immersed in her Irish heritage, she was immersed in her faith also. That in baptism, she became, like all of us of the baptized, something like Jesus, that is, a daughter of God and an heir to the kingdom of heaven. And one who is prepared to live a Christ-like life, which doesn't necessarily mean, and most of the time it doesn't, at least perfectly anyways, means that we have to sacrifice in this here life. That we have to, or called upon, yes, we look after our own legitimate immediate needs, but that we are prepared to give of ourselves and help in any particular kind to those who need it. In fact, Jesus was very, very explicit about this, you know. I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, et cetera, et cetera. Enter into the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Bernadette is not just going into a grave. That's where her material body, and we reverently look after it and repose it in a grave to await the resurrection of the body. But the essence of her being and her soul goes to God. What is God going to do? Well, something of this healing part here. But there's some things that, again, we're not given any explicit detail about this. Jesus said on one occasion, you must be perfect as your heavenly Father is perfect. Well, I think all of us have heard the saying, you know, nobody's perfect. But to gain heaven, we must be. And that's something that we cannot attain by ourselves. In the letter of Paul to the Hebrews, yes, he has a vision of heaven with God and angels and saints. And he also says present, the souls of just men made perfect. Now that is a very great mystery. We know the tragedy, the violence, the hardships of people around this here globe. It is a strange and ironic thing that however intelligent we are, whatever inventiveness we can produce in science, in space, in medicine, or whatever, we suffer war, other means of hurting one another. But just consider when Jesus speaks of perfection, he means to live a life without that. On December the 8th each year, we celebrate the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception, Mary, prepared by God to receive the very person of the second in within her. Being made immaculate is not a secondhand consideration. It is an absolute necessity, and it is ours too. What an existence to look forward to when there is no more war or violence or any other way that human beings hurt themselves, and no more fear. You know, there's a line in the some of the books of the Old Testament that say, the fear of God is the first stage of wisdom. And when it says fear of God, it doesn't mean sort of a crunching fear that God's gonna come down and hurt us or whatever. It's the idea that, you know, we love somebody so much, we don't want to do anything to hurt them, to offend them. And so this is what we're looking forward to for Bernadette too, that she will come into the fullness of life and well-being and joy. One of the other things we know about this state, as I say, we must be perfect. The ultimate human experience is to see God. And for that, we absolutely must be perfect, and God will bring that about. In the Book of Revelation, it has this here lines. Again, the writer having a vision of heaven, he says, after this I looked, and behold, a great multitude which no man could number, from every nation, from all tribes and all peoples and tongues, and standing before the throne and for the Lamb of God. We won't be lonely in heaven. And then these mysterious words of St. Paul in his 1 Corinthians. What no eye has seen, nor ear heard, nor the heart of man conceived, what God has prepared for those who love him. And so we pray this Mass for Bernadette and offer our personal prayers that she will come to see her God, to be united with all her loved ones who have passed beyond her. And just to sum up that experience of dying and death and into a new and glorious life, St. Luke tells us, in the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Let us stand now for these prayers of intercession. The response is simply, Lord, hear our prayer. For Bernadette, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord. For Bernadette, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord. For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord. For Bernadette's family and friends, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord. for all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord. And for all family and friends, neighbors, who were good to Bernadette during her life, we pray to the Lord. And now, at her baptism, there would have been at least a short litany of the saints. And it is our Catholic tradition to turn to the saints to pray with us and strengthen our prayer. At the name of each saint, I just ask you to respond with, pray for her. Holy Mary, Mother of God.
Pray for her.
St. Michael the Archangel.
Pray for her.
All angels and archangels.
Pray for her.
St. John the Baptist.
Pray for her.
St. Joseph.
Pray for her.
St. Peter and St. Paul.
Pray for her.
St. John the Apostle.
Pray for her.
St. Stephen and St. Lawrence.
Pray for her.
St. Ambrose.
Pray for her.
St. Bernadette of Lourdes.
Pray for
her. All holy virgins and widows.
Pray for
her. All saints of God.
Pray for her.
And now the response is, O Lord, deliver her from all evil.
O Lord, deliver her.
From the rigor of your justice.
O Lord, deliver her.
From long enduring sorrow. From enduring darkness, through your admirable conception, through your holy nativity, through your most profound humiliation, through your infinite love, through your anguish and sorrow, through your scourging, through your crying of the cross, your most holy, your most cruel death, your most holy wounds, through your holy resurrection, through the coming of the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete, on the day of judgment. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, our Redeemer, you willingly gave yourself up to death so that all people might be saved and pass from death into a new life. Listen to our prayers. Look with love on your people who mourn and pray for Bernadette. Lord Jesus, you alone are holy and compassionate. Forgive her sins. By dying, you open the gates of life for those who believe in you. Do not let Bernadette be parted from you, but by your glorious power, give her light, joy, and peace in heaven where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, and will become for us the bread of life. With the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, humble himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, and will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord. May our sacrifice and your sacred day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Please stand.
humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Bernadette. We beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim, Holy,
holy,
holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna
in the highest. At this point, Catholics use the kneel. If you're not Catholic, you may kneel or sit as you feel comfortable. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we be nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, and whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for failing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you,
And your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Bernadette, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth you will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you with their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good, through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Please stand. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in their days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with
at this point, we usually offer a handshake of peace to those nearby. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to be seated. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. At this point, those who are Catholic are invited forward on the side of the casket. If you're not Catholic or you're not prepared as a Catholic to receive, you may come forward and just receive a blessing like this. Otherwise, you may be seated.
Thank you.
Please stand. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, Bernadette may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Book Revelation, the writer there has a vision of heaven and with angels there with the thurible or have incenses. And the smoke from that is represents the prayers of God's people rising to God in heaven. My Redeemer lives, and on the last day I shall rise again. In my body I shall look on God, my Savior. I myself shall see him, my own eyes will gaze on him. This is the hope I cherish in my heart. Saints of God, come for aid, come for me, dear angel of the Lord, receiver, soul, and presenter to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to Abraham's side. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. Let your eyes. May she rest in peace. May her soul and all the souls of the faithful departed in the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Bernadette, your servant. In the sight of this world, she is now dead. In your sight, may she live forever. Forgive whatever sin she committed through human weakness, and in your goodness grant her everlasting peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Your friends, may every mark of affection and every gesture of friendship that you give to others be a sign of God's peace with you. In peace, let us take Bernadette to her place of rest.
you again, pallbearers. We're going to be going to Mountain View Cemetery. Does everybody know how to get there?
Yes.
Very good. You're either welcome to follow behind us, or we can meet you there, whichever you're more comfortable with. Okay. Fraser and 33rd, to the north side.
Thank you so much.
We'll see you there shortly.
I think we're scheduled to be there for 12, so we're
12:30.
Thank you. 12:30, so we'll have a little bit of
time. Thank you.
Of course. That's fine. That's what we're doing.
Yeah, I heard stories.